It's me, Rame from MBA.
Business.
Market Business Africa. Business Africa. Forgot.
Yeah, I'm always forget.
Now, today we are going to talk about Tanzania. Tanzania is one of the country which I really like. There is a friend from Tanzania. She make the best cake in the world. I love her cake. She can make any style of cake you want. So today I wanna know more about Tanzania from Moses. Can you tell me what Tanzania is country about? What kind of business they do? How do they import? Is there a seaport? How good is the business market? Can you give me some information?
Tanzania, their language spoken in Tanzania is Swahili. So another thing from Tanzania, to do their its business, mostly people from there, they are Muslims. You see, if mostly people are Muslims in Tanzania, you can focus on the business which are related to Muslims people. If you can buy like this carpet from the that is from Muslim countries,
such as
like carpets.
From which Muslim country we can buy?
Yeah, like you can go like normally to Dubai, to Arabia, Saudi Arabia. So then it's very easy to import to Tanzania because there is a seaport.
Okay, so yeah. There's a seaport. So how do the seaport link Tanzania with another country? So how is the trading route?
The trading route is that the seaport for Tanzania, which is located in Dar es Salaam.
Dar es Salaam is the capital.
No, it's not the capital. It's where seaport is located.
Okay.
So the capital city is Dodoma.
Dodoma, so yeah. Dar es Salaam. So, but I heard a lot about Dar es Salaam more than Dodoma. Why is that?
Yeah, because it's near.
Dar es Salaam is very famous.
Yeah, it's very famous.
I was thinking it was always the capital.
Yeah, no, because it's a. I can say it's a commercial. It's a commercial area because it's even near to the seaport.
So how we can start a business in Tanzania? What we can do there? What kind of product they mostly like to buy other than carpet? How are the people? What language they spoke?
They speak. They normally speak Swahili.
Swahili, you're telling me. Can they understand English?
Yeah, they can understand English.
So it means that I can go and start my business with English only.
Yeah, you can start your business in English. And
not like Congo or Burundi where you need to know their language of French.
Yeah, to speak the English, it's very good because you are lucky. If you are like a guy from Asia, it's very easier because there are mostly people from Asia are there in Tanzania doing business.
Okay, so yeah. Can you tell me about the market? I mean, what people like to consume there, like what product can sell well?
The product can sell well. You can easily focus on the product which is not there. You see, like if there are many people from Asia, you can easily bring the products from Asia because many people who are living there, they will consume them, such as like clothes for Muslims, because it can give a high demand. Yeah, which is different to Rwanda.
So you mean
and
the
Colombia.
Muslim clothing can sell well there?
Yeah, Muslim clothing can sell.
So is a tip. You can easily get a Muslim clothing from China, Thailand or Vietnam. What you are waiting for? I mean, come to Tanzania and start your business. So I think that's enough for the insight. Do not forget to subscribe. Also, I want to know which next country we should discuss. It was me, Rame, with Moses from MBA Market.
Business Africa.
Yeah. Bye.